Hi, welcome to Canada Connect, where it's all about connecting businesses to businesses and businesses to consumers. We've had some phenomenal people in the past, and today it is again an absolute pleasure talking to this wonderful human being. And I'm sure people who know him can vouch for this wonderful man who's done, who's been around for so long in the community and has been around in GTA for so long and has put up, various different shows and helped the community and helped so many people with their mortgages and whatnot, probably in their relationships and in their life. So without further ado, Mihir Oza, welcome to Canada Connect.
Thanks a lot, Mitul. It's my pleasure. Of course, it's a good time that we have chosen that people are back from the work, yes, or business. And of course, we don't want anyone driving and watching our feed. You can always go to our links afterwards and watch it.
Yes.
Thank you so much for having me today.
Perfect. Thank you. So for people who are new to this, you probably may see a description that says just allow StreamYard to basically allow you to post something or to comment something or so on. And this is live, but of course, the video will stay on the groups and on both our profiles to share and to view again as well. If you have any questions, feel free to pop in and Mihir will be able to answer. Of course, it's a lot of information about mortgages that are going to be there, and but before we jump into mortgages and why we are here and why Mihir and so on, let's understand who's Mihir and where did you start, and tell us a little more about Mihir. Where did you come from?
Yeah, absolutely. So Mitul said, my name is Mihir Oza. I live in Brampton, been a Bramptonian for the past more than 15 years now. Okay. I came to Canada in 2002 and was up in Etobicoke for the first 2-3 years. And being in the mortgage industry is something that I had never thought of, dreamt of. It's like luck by chance, you can say. Way back in 2009, we had started off a sports club, Jai Ho Sports Club, those who might be familiar with it. And we had a cricket team as well. So we were playing in some of our local tournaments. And then I came across actually one of the other teams, which was from Home Life franchisee, from a real estate agent. And then the team comprised of realtors, mortgage professionals, lawyers, home inspectors, and all of that mix. And then while playing, of course, you bond, right? Because sports, that's where you learn that, it's not about competition, but it's more of collaboration. Yeah. And that's where I actually came up to know about this field. And then I took my license in 2011.
Wow.
So proudly been in the industry for 9 years now.
Fantastic.
And mortgages is what I do.
Fantastic. But and Mihir, back home was where? I'm not sure. Did you, you came from India?
Yes, I came from India. I have a unique connection with the word B. I was born in Banga in Punjab, in a village. My mother was Punjabi. My father was Gujarati.
Nice.
Then raising up was in Baroda, another B.
Okay.
My first job was in Valsad, but of course, previously it was called Balsar. So limited. That's where I started off.
Nice.
Then the second job was in Baruch with Pepsi.
Okay.
And then came to Canada, of course, 3 years in Etobicoke, but now in Brampton again. So B.
Nice.
So the B keeps on going.
Fantastic.
And being a Piscean, I'm always near to the water. So even right now, my place in Brampton has a streamlet, which I can see from my backyard. So
that's awesome.
It's good to be besides water.
That's great. And you have a family of two daughters?
Daughter and a son.
One daughter.
She's just finished her first year in medical sciences at Western University.
Great.
And my son will be growing to grade 10 in September. He's in the IB program at Fenton.
Fantastic. A very happy belated Father's Day to you as well.
Thank you so much.
Perfect. Bihir, I had read, of course, we've been, both of us have been connected for, I think, a long time now. I've lost count for sure. But, of course, you've been very supportive of even the events that I've done with this new real estate field that I'm starting with. And in some way, we are connected because real estate, mortgage, they go hand in hand. And of course, just in general, helping people in Canada, within Canada. I read somewhere on Facebook as well, you had a very humble beginning. Like I remember, I think you were I think doing odd jobs at some point of time, and you know, and the reason I bring this up in today's conversation is because I want people to know, whoever are seeing this as well, that you know what, everybody has a different start, everybody has a different journey, everybody goes through a certain tough time. I think and correct me if I'm wrong or if I'm mixing somebody's post, I believe you at some point were even delivering newspapers at some point of time, if I'm not
mistaken.
That's
right.
So and from there to now helping people with their finances, that's a long, you know, that's like shows a man behind that he's going to do what it takes to support the family, to, you know, make a living, to make a career, to make this home. And the reason why I bring all this up is that when a viewer or when somebody is looking for a person who's going to go that extra mile to help them with their mortgage, that's why, you know, connect with me here. There's so many mortgage agents. Again, you know, I'm not saying that, but you know, the person who wants to take that extra step, is willing to work that hard, and you know, and who's gone through that trouble or that struggle when they've got their first home, and then so on and so forth. And you understand those pains, when especially for home buyers, when they are, you know, when they're so new, and now with so many new rules coming up and changing from July 1st. So we're going to talk about all of those in a minute. But, you know, Amir, that's a great story. And, you know, you are here because of a reason. And, you know, keep up the good work. That's all I can say.
Yeah,
you know, hard work always pays. So,
yes.
So now let's jump into mortgages. So almost 2011, so almost what, 10 years?
Yeah.
Wow, that's excellent. And tell us a little more. You know, first let's bring the elephant in the room, the new CMHC rules that are going to be changing in. Give us a little bit insight about that.
So there's good news and bad news.
Okay.
Let's talk about the bad news first, right?
Okay.
Because let's get it out of the way.
Yes, yes.
So of course, the government has announced that we'll be having new mortgage rules kicking in from 1st of July.
Okay.
Not a excellent Canada Day gift for people. But so basically, people who are doing less than 20% down payment mostly are, of course, the first-time home buyers.
Yeah.
So there are major three rules that are changing. So the one is that your credit score, and credit is always important. You might have an excellent job, you might have good down payment, but if your credit is bruised or not that great, it's always an issue. So they've actually increased the benchmark now. So they're looking for credit scores 680 plus.
Okay.
Previously, a lower credit score with one of the applicants was also sufficient enough.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing that they have done is the GDS and the TDS ratios. So these ratios are something wherein you qualify based upon your income and your ability to carry the mortgage and other expenses. The other expenses would be the heat, the property taxes, those kind of things. So those ratios have been curtailed down. So typically what that translates into right now, that if somebody was qualifying for a 500,000 mortgage,
mm-hmm.
come July 1st onwards, their income is not changing, the down payment is not changing, but now they'll be qualifying for a lesser home, approximately depending on where they fit in, maybe 40,000 less.
Okay.
So that is another change. But of course, having said that, the great news is there are two other insurers, Genworth and Canada Guarantee, who have so far said that, no, we are not going to implement the CMHC rules.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the good news because, yes, and being a mortgage broker in that space,
mm-hmm.
we have access to, of course, multiple lenders.
Right.
We just don't work with banks. Banks, there by default, all applications, any of the major six banks of Canada, they are sending it to CMHC.
Right.
But then, yeah, we have those other options as well. And
right.
in fact, the other day, TD has come up with their policy as well that, yes, okay. we will first send the deal to CMHC.
Right.
And if the person is not qualifying, then we'll, of course, consider it with Canada Guarantee or Genworth as well. So
right.
yeah, there are times are changing. It's not the space like 10 years ago, 20 years
right.
ago.
Right.
Mortgages, yeah, it's something that you need to definitely be much aware of. And especially when you are in the home buying process. I'm sure, Mitul, you do come across your clients.
Exactly. There are so many people who've, in a way, kept it, at least for the next week or two, they've kept it on hold because they're like, because maybe the CMHC is coming in. And a lot of people, you know, the whole thing is CMHC has done such good branding for themselves. Nobody knows about, or not enough people know about, or a common man doesn't know about the Canna Guarantee or the Genworth Financial as much, right? Like, even when you initially talk about insurances or when you're discussing, they're like, yeah, you know, there will be a CMHC field apply. Nobody talks about. So why does the bank deal so much with CMHC, you know, when there are two other options as well? Is it their first preferred? You know, can you share?
Yeah, that's by default. I mean, that's what the trend has been. The financial institution, the monoline lenders, credit unions, obviously they are into a different space because their money that is in the big pie, which they lend out, it all depends on the people who are lending the money. So their insurance portfolio is, of course, what caters to Genworth and Canada Guarantee as well. Right. But yeah, banks typically, they are by default with CMHC.
Right. So but then, now there may be a possibility now that even the banks may be open because, you know, naturally banks, the primary thing or one of the primary objectives of bank is to lend money. And if a lot of people are, you know, not going to in some way go to them because of this big CMHC thing, then I'm sure in time they will also start moving or inclining towards the Canada Guarantee or the Genworth, probably, right? Again, only time will tell.
But then, of course, having said that, banks still have about 60-65% of the market share between bank versus the broker. Okay. So the broker channel has actually gone up. Previously, it used to be in the 20s, 25, 30%.
Right.
The ratios have been going up because obviously you need alternates. Just bank is not one thing that you go for your mortgage financing needs.
Exactly. And then again, for people who are watching and if they're thinking, because there's always a thought or a doubt that should I go to the bank directly or should I talk to a mortgage agent? You know, what I will share and then you can, of course, highlight. They can go to both in whichever way or they can shop around with both. But ideally, what I would think is if you're going to a certain bank and Mead, you can highlight that more. If you're going to a certain bank, they're going to talk about or they're going to discuss about the products that they have. It's like, you know, they may have product A, B, C, and these are the terms and conditions. But when you go to a mortgage agent like me here, and he's working with multiple financial institutions. Absolutely. So depending upon what your case is, what your, you know, paperwork is, what your finances are, what your assets or investments or debts or, you know, so on are, he will then make a case and then know, okay, this is the bank that will work for us, because eventually even the agent has to go to a bank because Mir is not giving the money out. It's the bank that is, or the financial institution that is giving. Mir, tell us a little bit about more. I hope I've not missed anything there.
No, absolutely. You're right. So Mitul, bank versus broker, that's always something that people think of.
Yes.
Both have the advantages, disadvantages. As you clearly highlighted, the bank, you approach your financial institution where you do the banking, the salary comes in, or as a self-employed professional.
Right.
Yes, absolutely. Approach them, ask them what their rates are, what the terms and conditions, what are the products they can offer you. But at the same time, keep in mind that there are many things that a broker brings to the table that a bank would not be able to. Right. Just to highlight a few things that, right now, let's say you've got a mortgage with me here. I'm here. This is where I get the earning. You get a mortgage with a bank, no harms, absolutely. Yeah. But the person that you dealt with, what if in 2 or 3 years you're needing some advice? That person might not be still with that bank or at that same branch.
Correct.
That personal connect, which is very important, because the guidance that you would be getting in, because at the end of the day, this is what eventually puts food on our tables, right?
Exactly.
So the personal connect is very important. And of course, absolutely, there's like more than 40, 50 lenders. Not every lender is something that you would be needing because every client has a different need.
Right.
But looking around for rates, that's the best thing because there's no harm in doing that.
Correct.
You should definitely shop around, compare products, compare services. But just keep in one mind, which people do forget, that what's the best rate is the first question. Let's talk about what are the features of that rate.
Right.
Because in the market, you'll find all types of rates, and then you just don't want to end up into a big penalty mortgage that you realize only after 3 or 4 years that they'll call, hey, Mithul, my family is now growing up. Find me a bigger place. Mithul, absolutely, let's do that.
Yeah.
Did you check on your mortgage? No, not really. Let me check. And they call the bank or they call the broker. And in case if they were not guided properly, unfortunately, then it's an unpleasant surprise that many people find themselves in.
Exactly.
In fact, a couple of weeks ago, there was an article.
30,000
of a lady. Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. So, yes, those things are.
Sorry, tell us a little bit more for people who didn't, because when I read it, trust me, when I read it for a minute, I'm like, what the leap, you know?
So, see, then it comes to the point on fixed versus variable mortgages, right? Fixed mortgages, you know that, okay, let's say 2,500 is my monthly payment. For the next 5 years, I'm paying 2,500 no matter what.
Right.
Best thing to do.
Right.
Variable mortgages, right now you might be at 2,300, you might be at 2,700 also.
Right.
But then with variable mortgages, as the Bank of Canada's interest rate goes up and down, your mortgage payments can fluctuate. But the best part of variable mortgages is that if after 3 years, 4 years, if you're moving or you are doing refinance, things might change in life.
Right.
So then it just carries a 3 month interest only penalty.
Right.
Wherein the case that was quite popular, wherein a lady had to sell her property because of the COVID situation.
Mm-hmm.
And then she was up against like 25, 30,000 as a penalty because she was in a fixed mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
And fixed mortgages have a steeper penalty. It's interest rate differential, and that can vary each day. Like today, it might be X amount, and tomorrow the penalty would be different. So fixed mortgages, as much as they are best in terms of a fixed payment that you have nothing to worry for the next 5 years, but God forbid, and honestly, in Canada, typically after 3 to 4 years, people's needs change. They might be looking for a bigger property. They want to refinance. They want to take out the equity and invest in something else.
Right.
So overall, variable mortgages, and of course, the guidance step one, that's very important to have.
Right. Also, I want to highlight, while you said about the step one, that why a broker, of course, you know, we know that, yes, there are banks. People can go to the banks, they can talk and so on and so forth. But today, let's talk a little more about why a broker, right? So in terms of a broker, right, so that people also know that they are not directly paying the broker. Example, let's say when if Mithul comes with a file, hey, I'm looking for a $500,000 mortgage. Mihir, what's the case? Here are my paperwork, and I submit to you. So in some way, people have to understand that Mithul is in no way paying Mihir, even though Mihir is giving me all the advice, giving me all his time, giving me all his expertise. In some way, Mihir still gets paid by the bank. So people have to understand that when you're going to an agent or a broker, you're using all the professional services, you're using all the knowledge. Sometimes if Mihir is working with one of the top financial institutions, sometimes Mihir may have some great rates that may not be available in the market as well. So those are benefits that you can get when you're going through and agent, you know, and again, each case is different, each file is different, and he basically can help you analyze, where you position, where you do stuff. And I'm reading back there on your banner as well, with one credit check, you will then go around and, shop for your best mortgage rate possible, instead of, Mithul going and knocking five banks and then, okay, yesterday it's available, I'm not available. So plus time-wise, if you want to talk to an agent or again, you want to talk to Mihir at 7 in the night, you will meet him. Mihir does a lot of good Gujarati Dandiya events as well. While playing Dandiya with Mihir, you can say, Maru mortgage approved. So it's the accessibility is there, and you can meet them at the comfort of your home or office.
Absolutely.
Or at Tim Hortons. So my advice would be talk to an agent, talk to Mihir, and then you'll be able to get more information from there on. Mihir, tell us for first time, like currently there are like super low rates in the market. What's the prime rate right now?
So that's 2.45. That's the prime rate right now. The variable mortgages are excellent. I have a couple of lenders who are at prime minus 47. That's 1.98. That's 1.98. Having said that, this is for high ratio mortgages. Correct. And keep in mind that a few years back, the rules changed. Mm-hmm. So there are different rates for high ratio mortgages and for conventional mortgages, conventional being 20% and more down payment. But having said that, even with conventional mortgages, you are looking anywhere around 2.5 as an average or lower, not more than that.
Can you tell people who never dealt about mortgages or people who don't understand this lingo, what is a high ratio mortgage? Or can you tell us a little bit who considers or qualifies in that genre, so to speak? Yes.
Yeah. So high ratio mortgages, Mithul, is anyone doing a down payment of less than 20%. Okay. So let's say if they are buying a property of 500,000, if they are doing less than 100,000 as the down payment, so they would be under high ratio mortgages. Their amortization is 25 years. Okay. And as we like mentioned earlier, the CMHC fees, the insurance is applied, which is added onto the mortgage itself.
Okay.
And that's where the main differentiation comes. For conventional mortgages, that's 20% and more down payment. Their amortization is 30 years.
Okay.
A few years back, we had 35 years. Many years back, we had 40 years as mortgage amortization. Wow. Of course, gone are those days. Yeah. So right now, once again, conventional mortgages as well, absolutely great rates. The best time to be in the market if someone is sitting on the fence, and I'm sure many of your clients, absolutely would be seeing that, Mithul, you know what, let's wait another 2 weeks, a month, the prices would drop down, I'll go for it. You know what, there's never a better time than today.
That's
because you don't foresee tomorrow. Nobody can.
Exactly.
Even the best of our professions, and I'll tell you even my story, for example. In November, I had my 5 years renewal. Okay. And being in the mortgage space, obviously, as I said, variable is, of course, the best way to go forward.
Right.
The variable rates, and by the way, just so that people are knowing about this, the rate I get is what I can get you, Mithul.
Wow. Okay.
I don't get any perfect special rates.
Okay.
Being in the mortgage space, that I can't give you the same rate, right? That's how it happens. So my mortgage, and having said that, my mortgage is with AMCAP. I've always been with them. Banks, no harm. We can, of course, discuss in detail some other time or later on, one-on-one with the clients as well.
Sure.
But so the offer I was looking at was a renewal of fixed at 2.49. Mm-hmm. And whereas the variable rates were much higher, was around 2.95, if I remember correctly. Wow. Now, in November, so while this was happening, so in October, November, I was like, yeah, you know what? No. The market is going strong. We'll have a greater strength next year in the economy.
Yeah.
And 2.49, I don't see interest rates going down.
Yeah.
Being in the industry as well. Yeah. Who had foreseen COVID happening?
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
And of course, then we had 0.5 decrease.
The market
decrease.
Was going strong. Yeah.
It was. Absolutely. Yeah. And then suddenly in March, we had 3 rate decreases of 0.5, which is totally unprecedented in the history of Canadian mortgages.
Correct.
Absolutely. Right now, we are at 2.45. Those who had, like previously, by the way, I was at 1.8. I was prime minus 9 in the previous term.
Nice.
But that's okay. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, today is the best day. If you keep waiting for tomorrow that, prices will go down, maybe the rates will drop. No. Yeah. You know what? Yeah. Just go for it. Because keep in mind, right now, if you're renting, you are paying your landlord's mortgage.
Exactly. Oh, wow. Thank you. I'm glad you brought this up because this, I am so glad you brought this up because, you know, there are so many people who are of this mentality that let's rent. Why do we want a headache of, of having a mortgage on our head and how will we be able? Of course, every situation is different. So I'm not saying every person who is currently renting should immediately jump into and buy a house. But this is the time. Like if ever you were thinking about making that switch, now is the time. Rental rates are any, as soon as the market goes up a little bit, rental rates are going to go up. Things are going to get expensive. And so don't wait. You know, eventually your home is your home. And instead of paying, like you correctly said, paying somebody else's mortgage, you pay your own mortgage. Eventually you're building your equity. So in the long run, that's much more of a capital benefit for you.
And sorry, just I'll add a couple of things.
Please.
Keep in mind.
Yes.
Rentals right now are low. Why? Because think about this. Immigration is right now stopped. Literally stopped.
Yeah.
I believe we had less than 10,000 people in the last couple of months that immigrated to Canada, because obviously Canada has stopped people who are who have already been approved, but they're not letting in people right now because of the COVID situation.
Right.
Of course, work permit and those things are on hold as well. But once the economy picks up, maybe in the next few months or by the end of the year, absolutely, the rentals are going to go up again. So today, I mean, right now it's the best time, and of course we have longer evenings.
So. Yeah, no, exactly. No, even like I think the biggest thing is even the interest rate, right? Like if there is a possibility and if you qualify to get one of those 1.98% or even if it's 2.45, let's say you get it at prime or whatever the situation, it's still it's not a high amount. You know, can you imagine the market was stronger and if you're paying 5%, 6%, like you would be paying so much more money. So and again, not to forget, like as if the property rates do go low, let's say, because I've had so many of these conversations with some of my clients as well, some of my leads, that hey, you know what, the property value may drop. Let's say it drops 5,000. It may drop 10,000. You think that the mortgage rates are going to be the same? Immediately, the mortgage rates are going to jump up. And if they jump up, that's it. Now you're paying more money in interest. So give or take, here or there, eventually we are working for these financial institutions.
Absolutely.
And eventually, we need to first make sure that we pay them. They are happy. We are happy. So
exactly.
Yeah. No, but I think it's always, you know, I've always been off that, that figure out a way, like, you know, what happens is when people immediately jump into, I want to buy a home. Right now, they're living probably in a basement or a one-bedroom condo and so on. Suddenly, when they get into this buying space, I don't know why they suddenly want to jump into, let me now have my fancy two-bedroom and a backyard and a swimming pool and, you know, go slow, like, get your next property, whatever you can afford, be it a studio, a one bed, talk to a mortgage advisor, how much can you qualify for? And then you jump into the next step after 3 years, after 5 years, to move into a bigger home and you build yourself, you grow. You know, you don't want to just suddenly have, and that's why they're always on the fence, because when they want to buy, so large, then they're going to get stuck. And then they're just paying, again, like you said, the landlord's mortgage, you know?
I mean, at the end of the day, of course, everyone's personal choice.
Yes, absolutely.
But how we have grown up, how our parents have always taught us that pay yourself first, make sure that your expenses are being covered with your income. So keep that in mind. Yes. There's always that opportunity in the future that once you grow, once there's more prosperity, and of course, take the equity, take it to the next home. You might be, even myself, when I bought my first home in 2005, I believe I had done a 7 or 8% down payment. But then, of course, when I went to this current home in 2016, it was with more than 20% down payment. So take that equity and build it on a bigger scale afterwards.
Correct. No, that's absolutely no. I surely appreciate Mir, you sharing. I'm just going to quickly check if I had some questions. Some people have reached out to find out. We've spoken. Oh yeah, this is an important one. We spoke about buy or rent. We spoke about low rates, variable and fixed interest. Anything else they should consider? You know, let's say when we were talking about the ratios, apart from the maintenance, the taxes, and the things that come with that, important thing to consider is your debts as well, right? Like if you have a car, if you have some outstanding phone bills, can you give us a little highlight on that?
Absolutely, it's a great point that you brought in, Mithul. Many times, what happens is that all people do is let's say my family income is 80,000, great. Credit cards I pay off every month, absolutely great. I have a car loan, let's say 250 is the monthly, great. And afterwards they remember that actually I had one of my cousins was buying a car and he was not getting approved, so I was a guarantor. Those things come up. My friend, that's on your credit, and that's your liability.
It would show up on their report as well, right? The guarantor shows up on there. If they pull up their Equifax or TransUnion, it will show up on there. Right?
Yeah. Okay. So even the other common myth, and in fact, about half an hour before we started off, I was talking to a client of mine, and he has his upcoming home. He has booked a builder's home, which is coming up for possession maybe later this year.
Okay.
And he was discussing his scenario. So he has his current home, and then he has another property with a partner of his.
Okay.
So he was like, okay, I have 400,000 left on that mortgage with the partner. So my liability is 200,000. I said, no, it's not 50-50. It's 400,000.
Correct.
So these are some of the things that, just be educated so that make sure that when you are going for the next step. So now he is having to sell one of his properties, either the current home that he is like living in or the one which he has a, as an investment with a partner, because otherwise he won't qualify for the home that he is going to get later this year. So these are important things. Make sure, and by the way, Equifax, that is the best, and that's what we use.
Okay.
There are many other websites as well, wherein you get free reports and all, but Equifax is the one that we consider.
Okay.
And make sure that every year you can get your report, except the score, you can get it for free.
Okay.
And why it's important to do is that anytime, and it happens in a lot of our South Asian like clients as well, the names are same, and then somebody else's credit gets merged, or of course frauds and those kind of things.
Right.
So monitoring your credit is very important. Make sure that if there's anything that is on your report which is not yours, a credit card, a line of credit, just make sure that it's taken off. Let Equifax know. Many times I've seen my clients that the purchase agreement has come in, we got 5 business days, I pull up the credit, and what? There's other people's credit on it, and then it takes time. You can't get it done within those 5 business days. So most important, and one thing never to forget, you have a dispute with your Bell, Rogers, any phone, phone providers and all, absolutely go and fight for it.
They are notorious. They are known for these things, you know. It's
absolutely. If you don't pay, they send it to the credit collection agency after a couple of months. And once it's on a report, that's not good. Absolutely. It may be a $50. Yeah, outstanding.
But it punctures your credit score, right? People don't realize it. I've seen it with my, with some of my close friends as well. And suddenly they're like, oh, we made all our bills and we paid everything. And suddenly when they pulled up, I won't name the company, but one of the communication companies has put that, and it just dropped and, you know, degraded their score. And it's taken a while, and then so on and on. So even after paying it up, it was still left. So, you know, it's very important to get that check. And you from your experience, you prefer Equifax over even a TransUnion, because those are what are commonly
Right? Absolutely. So with us in the mortgage space, when we pull the credit, it's only Equifax.
Okay.
That's what all the lenders use.
Okay.
There might be some who might use TransUnion, but 90% and more, it's Equifax. So just
and
go with
some
that.
Some people, especially newcomers or new home buyers or new people who are moving into this industry or in this space, basically, a lot of times they feel that, hey, if I'm pulling my own credit score, will it's going to affect my credit score? It's going to hit it. Can you give us a little more about that?
So there's always
the score, basically.
Absolutely. Yeah. So there's the hard check and the soft check.
Right.
So twice a year, if you're doing a credit check by yourself, doesn't impact your score. You can also subscribe to the credit monitoring as well. So then you get those reports updated whenever there's any new application done.
Nice.
Earlier, we talked about shopping around for rates and all. You go to bank A and you apply over there. They'll do a credit check. You go to bank B. Then you go to a broker. And then you might want to compare with another broker. Each time that you apply, that's a new credit check that gets hit.
Exactly.
There's always this myth, as well as the fact that, okay, if in a certain time period, if I'm doing those credit checks, it's fine. Yes, absolutely. But then keep in mind that too many checks is going to impact your score. the algorithms is very complicated, to be very honest. You go to a professional and it's very hard. Okay, is it 20 points? Is it 10 points? How many points are getting deducted and all? But at the end of the day, keep in mind that a credit score, which is 720 plus, is what you should be aiming at. Okay. Everybody starts at the full highest score. And then as you keep on applying for credit, you pay off, the credit score goes up and down. But 720 plus is what you should be aiming at.
Okay, perfect. No, this is all really great insights. And I appreciate you giving us the time here. Of course, Mihir's numbers are flashing throughout. His website is right there. In case if you have any further questions, please feel free to reach out to Mihir about anything to do with mortgages, and he can just help you, he can assist you, he can guide you. Even if you just have a question, hey, this is what I'm thinking, you know, feel free to talk to Mihir. And the good thing is, I know he's extremely prompt and he'll reply right away. If he's not, he's probably helping another client. So just give it some time and he will definitely be in touch with you. Mihir, anything else? I have one other question to ask you before I let you go. Anything else about mortgages you want to tell somebody, or new people, or, you know, somebody now during this stage, a lot of people were moving towards the HELOC. Any little bit light about that you would want to share?
So HELOC, it's always good, especially if you're doing 20% and more down payment.
Okay.
Get into a product which the banks are providing, or even sometimes the financial institution backed with the bank. Mm-hmm. It's something that it's like credit is something that when you are at the best of income, your health and everything, you might not need it. Right. Just keep it with you. No harm in having that credit approved. But right. God forbid, like COVID, many people lost their jobs. All these mortgage deferrals came in. Yes. Even yesterday, I got a call. And by the way, yeah, in the mortgage space, there's no holiday. We work, of course, Monday to Sunday.
Exactly.
Having said that, it's you don't have the work-life balance, but reach out anytime. So a lady called in yesterday. She is a single mom and she has been my client for a few years now. And she was like, Mihir, I did apply for a mortgage deferral, but you know what? I'm still not out of the woods. What should I do? So those are the things. I mean, definitely reach out. But had she had the home equity line of credit, she would have been able to tap in right now. So go for it. And most important, and this is a message out to every buyer, when you buy a property or you go for a bigger property, make sure you have a life insurance that covers at least the mortgage amount.
The value of the property. Or
absolutely.
The mortgage.
Yes. So that is there. Now, of course, there's mortgage insurance, which the banks and, of course, all the institutions would be selling you at.
Right.
But definitely consult with the life insurance advisor.
Right.
Compare that as well.
Like a term life or a full life.
Absolutely. A term and a whole life.
Right.
Absolutely do that. Because my role is for mortgages. Of course, I'll educate on the insurance part.
But talk to a professional.
Just because you are getting the mortgage through me doesn't mean that you have to take insurance from me. Till this date, Mithul, not a single mortgage insurance in the last 9 years.
Oh, okay.
I've not done that.
Okay.
Yeah, because obviously, term insurance, life insurance, those are better products as well. And absolutely, at the end of the day, you know, guiding them properly is what we are in this field for.
Exactly. And no, you're known for that. You are known for that. You know, you're known to help people in the community. You're known to help, you know, startups come up, and you're known, like just recently you started this, you know, giving your space on Facebook to all these superstars in Canada and GTA. I don't know which all provinces you're reaching out to. And so people, if you've not seen that, please go. He started something called Who and What and Why, and, you know, highlighting these people and giving them a platform to shine. And so thank you, Mihir. You've supported so many different businesses and startup companies and organizations. Please continue to do so. And you yourself are such a hardworking professional. So all the good wishes to you. One last thing before I let you go is what is that one, which I ask all my people, is what is that one mantra that you go by? What wakes up Mihir in the morning and says, you know what, I love my life and I'm going to do this. So what is that mantra?
So basically, there's no shortcut to success.
Okay.
Just keep working hard.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, yesterday might be something that was not great. Tomorrow you don't know about, but all you have in hand is your today. So
Fantastic.
Make it the best that you have today.
Fantastic. Perfect. No, thank you, Bihir. It's been an absolute pleasure talking to you. Anything else I've missed out on? Anything else you would like to talk about? You know, you're more than welcome. We can always get on a call like this again and, you know, talk more about it, more about mortgages. If anybody has any questions, feel free to reach out. Anything you would want to go say before we close off, Bihir?
No, keep shining, Mithul. I'm sure you would be quite busy in the next couple of months as well.
Yes.
And good luck to you. And we are looking forward with any feedback, anything that people would like to hear. We can always have a shout out later in the summer or in the fall as well.
Perfect. Perfect. Excellent. Thank you, Bihir, once again for giving us your time. You have any questions related to mortgages, reach out to me, Rosa. His numbers, his websites, everything is right there and there. He operates from Brampton, but of course, he can be anywhere in GTA. You can call in. You can do a video call with him. You are, you know, just thinking about mortgages. Just reach out once and see where it goes from there. Thank you for watching and stay tuned. If you know of somebody who would like to be featured on this show or has something great to talk about and share, be it a business to a business to a consumer, reach out to me. My details are below and have an amazing day. Take care. Thank
Thanks,
you.
Michael.
Thanks.